Hello everyone, and welcome to my first video. I am Leon, and I'm from the Netherlands. Oh, shit in a box. And yeah, this is my first video on my new channel, Leon Strange. And I'm gonna do a video review, of a locomotive review, however you say that, of a Hornby Railways locomotive, which I think is from the late 1980s. I have this little bit of a railway, if you can call that, windmill, signal box, siding, and a tunnel. And we also have some friends. We have Thomas the Tank Engine, a little robot, and a mini diesel from Germany. So let's get into the review. And here it is. It's a Hornby Railways Patriot class from the LMS, and it's a Duke of Sutherland. Oh, and it's with crew and vacuum pipes. Very good. And I got this with some, yeah, I don't know how to say that, but I got a little bit for cheap. It's 60 euros, but I actually got it for 55 euros. Because I'm a kid. If you didn't know that, because of my voice. And yeah, like I said, assuming of the box, I think that it's from the late 1980s. So let's open it. Oh, and here's the side. LMS Patriot class, Duke of Sutherland. And don't forget to give this video a like. Trying to get that out. Alright. Already can see the locomotive for a little bit. Here's a nice picture that you could see through the box. And maybe my English is a little bit bad, because mostly I talk with a British accent that I grew over the years, but let's not talk about that. So yeah, let's get into the locomotive. I'm gonna place this here, then grab it. So here is the locomotive itself. It's a tender driven model, and here's a little bag in the cab, and it has, oh sorry train, the figurines. So yeah, that's always nice, but I'm sure that I'm not gonna put them in. And I don't know if you can see that, but there's a cab interior. Very cool, very cool. And yeah, you can just run this however you want and stuff. Then we're gonna move on to the tender. So this is the tender. It's got the nice LMS and that nice red. I think you call it maroon red. Not sure. And same, but I don't think that you can see it. But there's also some coal. Yeah, and here's some foam. And this is a little bit loose. And here's the back with, I really don't know if you can see all of this, but with a very cheap molded hook. Not this one, but that one. That red bump. So yeah, let's put it on the layout, hook it together. And this is really unprofessional, but I'm gonna remind you, this is my first video, but I'm gonna... What I wanted to say was, I was gonna put on the power. Yeah. Let's have it go forward, I think. Oh no. Forward. Backwards. Oh, stopped on a point for some reason. Wait. It's a little bit twitchy, but it's very detailed. Let's do a little bit of a crawl. And that's good, in my opinion. Now let's do it backwards. That's also very good. Now let's run it for a loop. Yes, very nice. Very nice. So, runs very good for where from which time it's from. Which, like I said, I think is from the late 1980s. And I have some carriages from a Flying Scotsman train set. More on that in another video. And I'm gonna put them on the tender. And see how it runs. Yes, they are put on. And let's go running. Oh, it's derailing. That's better. Isn't that amazing? Oh, let's stop. I find it very amazing. I find it a very good train. And also, the price is, in my opinion, very low for how good it can run. And also, on looking to the packaging, I understand the price, but with the locomotive itself, not. So, yeah, if I got to put it in a rating of out of 10, I'm gonna give it a 9.5 out of 10. So yeah, that was it for this video. Like and subscribe. And keep in mind, this is my first video. And my name is Leon, and I'm out. Bye.